The Best Robot by Pedro Pablo Sacristán. XT-27 wasn't just any robot. His identification plate read, XT-27, the best, most modern robot. He was indeed the most up-to-date robot currently available. A product difficult to beat. Of course, this made him feel very proud. So much so that when he saw other robots on the street, he would look at them with a certain air of superiority. He reserved his enthusiastic greetings for other XT-27s.
All robots should be like us, XT-27s,
he thought to himself. He was convinced that no new robot would be able to improve on the XT-27 model, and that the world would be a much better place if all robots were like himself. One day, he was walking along in Bionic City when a big yellow door suddenly appeared. About an inch in front of his piezoelectric optical sensors. That's eyes to you and me. But XT-27 liked to use highly technical sounding words for everything. He had no idea where the door had come from. But thanks to being an XT-27, his quick reactions allowed him to avoid walking straight into it. Intrigued, he pulled it open and went through the doorway. The door led to a fantastic city. All the city's inhabitants were XT-27s, and everything he saw was mind-blowing. Excited about having found his perfect city, he set out to explore the whole place, stopping from time to time to talk to people, telling them what a great thing it was to be an XT-27.
Hello, like you, I am an XT-27. You are great. We both are. XT-27s are the best. I think I'll stay.
Finally, he moved into his molded fiberglass bubble, what you and I call a house, on the outskirts of the city. The days passed, but he suddenly realized that there was something about that city that he didn't like.
As all the robots here are XT-27s, it means that no one has any reason to feel better than anyone else. In fact, no one does. No one looks down on others. And if truth be told, I find that with the passing of time, not even I feel special anymore.
On top of that, things became very boring. Everyone could do things equally well, which made it impossible for anyone to stand out from the crowd. Whenever he did anything which he thought brilliant, it turned out that the other robots had done exactly the same thing at the same time. So, XT-27 started to miss those varied little robots in his previous world.
Each one has its good and bad points, but that's what makes them different and fun. I would much prefer to meet a clumsy but fun TP4 and spend a while chatting with it than see yet another XT-27.
So, he started searching for that big yellow door. It took him several days to find it, but he finally did. Just like before, it was standing in the middle of a normal street. He put his hand on the door and looked behind him, as if saying farewell to that city that had, at first, seemed so perfect. Then he gave the door a joyful push. When he woke up, the XT-27 was lying on the ground. Some people were helping him to his feet.
Oh, here's an XT-27 lying down. Here, come on, let me help you.
Thank you. Please help me.
I'll help you. Come here.
Please help me up.
I'll help you. Come here.
Thank you.
He looked around, and there was no yellow door at all. Instead, in front of him, there was an enormous, shiny, yellow robot. The XT-27 had bumped into it so violently.
We hope you enjoyed this preview.
To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.